Goodness, you're here.
She's requested time.
But we do not have time. Stand back.
No offence, sister, but I believe you are the last person she would like to see.
And what is that supposed to? Are we sure she's even in there?
Of course she is in there.
Where else would she be? Shh.
Climb through the window, escape through the chimney.
Quiet. She may hear you.
Do realise it.
Oh, spoke with such feeling, too.
I do not need feeling.
Might hold off on leasing them this year.
I didn't know you were back in town.
Bien sûr. Who else could dress these delicate debutantes for the season?
Does that mean I shall see you later on tonight? I hear there's a party.
I have much work to do, Mr. Bridgerton. And my art must come before all else. Enjoy your time.
Brother. Are you in the modiste still making a stitch?
Well, apparently not. Have you found a wife yet? Or are you planning to offend every young girl until there are none left?
Stop fussing with your dress.
You look lovely, dear.
I look like a prize calf trussed up for auction.
Even Daphne felt most apprehensive at her first official ball, and look how well her season turned out.
Right.
Come, sister. The cakes at these occasions are surprisingly good. Anyone here you've not yet rejected?
You're the artist. Do you see anyone remotely inspiring? We shall have our diamond tonight, and we shall have more.
If the Queen, in fact, names Eloise the diamond, whom will you marry then, brother?
Hush you.
Which I will do when I make Miss Edwina my Viscountess. Miss Edwina and I are well suited. She is a lovely young lady. She wishes for children. She'll make a perfectly agreeable wife.
What he means to say is that he has already dismissed every other young lady in town.
You take too much upon yourself, brother. Perhaps your life might be easier if you pursued someone with a less disagreeable sister.
No, but why should I be the one to admit defeat? Regardless of which young lady I'd chosen to pursue, there would have always been some obstinate father or meddlesome aunt in the picture. I shall certainly not let some sister, especially one younger than me, keep me from getting what it is I want.
Whom you want, you mean?
Is this still a friendly match, or do we need to find some armor?
That is what you do not understand, brother. Benedict honors me by holding nothing back. As I now honor him.
What honor?
Thank you, gentlemen, for the bracing exertion. But now it's time for me to secure my...
I need you to teach me how to read that out loud.
Byron? Did I strike you much harder than I realized earlier?
There is a pleasure in the pathless woods.
Ooh.
There is a rapture on the... How does one make that sound good?
I'm afraid that is not possible. That poem is the opposite of good. That poem's nonsense.
But I thought this sort of thing was supposed to be your pleasure.
Poetry, yes. Byron, heavens no.
Is not everyone supposed to love Byron?
Many in our year at Cambridge thought my poetry far superior to his.
Does that mean yours is more or less deceitful?
Deceitful?
Hmm.
Poetry's the opposite, brother. It's the art of revealing precious truth with words.
Yeah, quite right, brother. You're being serious?
Mm-hmm.
Good God. Good night.
What is it, truly, to admire a woman? To look at her and feel inspiration? To delight in her beauty, so much so that all your defences crumble, that you would willingly take on any pain, any burden for her. To honour her being with your deeds and words. That is what the true poet describes.
You should apply yourself more often, Benedict. Write that down.
I will admit my thoughts are far from the field. I have applied to become a student of art at the Royal Academy schools.
Have you? Well, congratulations.
Well, do not celebrate yet. I await word of my acceptance. They only invite a select few to study there, it seems.
But still, it's an exciting prospect.
Well, it's hardly a grand tour as you had with your travels, but
Yes, I do hope to distinguish myself too.
Then the devil.
Oh, that's bad.
Benedict, dear, you alarm our guests.
It's quite all right, Lady Bridgerton.
Perhaps. It is time for a toast.
A good idea. To cheer our guests.
Or to tend to other pressing matters.
I believe my sister and I have grown rather weary.
A toast. Are you still up? Oh, well, you may wish to bathe before you see Mother in the morning.
It's magical, brother. You're right. Oh, I've allowed my doubts to play me for too long. The Royal Academy School is not the arbiters of taste. The world is.
You are a fat wit.
Benedict, something has apparently arrived for you. A letter from London.
I have the place. The Royal Schools have accepted me as a student. I got in!
I thought they were not the arbiters of taste.
There must be great promise in my work. Oh, my! You shall all be...
Do you not think it true?
Perhaps your sister aimed straight on the field. But surely she would have some trouble managing.
Why would you assume I had any trouble managing at all, my lord?
I only mean to say...
Because I am a woman?
No. I did not say that.
But you thought it.
Ladies do not hunt.
Do not or are not allowed to.
I am certain Lady Danbury can spare me to act as chaperone. Oh, what fun you will all have. Getting to know each other all the better.
What an excellent idea, Miss Edwina. I don't think we can make an exception just this one time. We're on our private lands, after all, and who knows? Perhaps Miss Sharma can teach you a thing or two.
I declare, that's rather good.
I'm skilled at more than simply standing naked. Mr...
Bridgerton, I do not doubt it.
Then perhaps inform the Academy. Although two of the founding members are women, we are still not yet allowed to enter the classroom. At least not while we're clothed.
So you work as a model as a way of learning from the lectures. Ingenious.
Care to take a turn? It is harder than it looks.
Like so. How long must I stay like this?
That depends. What I really need is a study of the male form. The naked form. What say you?
Or must you choose just one?
He is much better than me, I will. Would be a shame for you to turn back now.
Steady.
I'm ready.